¿Qué tal? Bienvenidos a esta emisión de Negocios en tu Mundo. Más de 170 mil personas se dieron cita recientemente en la feria CES de Las Vegas, una de las más importantes en el ámbito tecnológico. Y aquí les tenemos un resumen especial, lo más novedoso, lo más llamativo, con los periodistas Gabriel Posada y Linda Bustamante.
Este programa es gracias a Confenalco.
Este año el CES o la Feria CES de Las Vegas termina convirtiéndose por accidente en la más importante de tecnología en el mundo, y no solo por la pasarela de emprendimientos, de comunidades y de empresas, sino por el coronavirus. ¿Y qué tiene que ver un argumento de salud con la tecnología? Pues todo. Se ha cancelado la Feria de Tecnología de Barcelona, por lo que se mostró en el CES termina siendo lo más importante en el mundo. Así que vamos a explorar qué pasa en la feria más importante en Las Vegas. Linda Bustamante.
Así es, Gabriel, y para mí es un gusto acompañarlos hoy en Negocios en tu Mundo. Y es que estuvimos presentes en la versión número 53 del Consumer Electronics Show. Escuchen estas cifras, más de 4.500 empresas, 1.200 líderes de pensamiento de la industria reunidos en un solo lugar y más de 20.000 innovaciones, lo que pudimos ver. Pero, ¿qué fue lo más interesante? Se los contamos en la siguiente nota.
Lo más importante en las tecnologías son las personas, y de esta manera Samsung está promoviendo la manera de enlazar las aplicaciones con los electrodomésticos y las personas. Dispositivos que se encargan de avisarle al teléfono cuando usted tiene un plazo para resolver algo en su casa. Vamos a ver la tecnología de Samsung, pero como si fuera poco, vamos a conocer el nuevo prototipo de taxi que va a ser una gran pelea entre las compañías que están diseñando aviones. Vamos a conocer el prototipo de Uber Taxi que ha desarrollado la Hyundai. Y por último, los exoesqueletos. Estas son tecnologías de biomecánica que le están ayudando a dar movilidad a las personas que tienen problemas motrices. Así que no es muy lejano a lo que pasa en la ciudad de Medellín, en donde la Universidad de Antioquia se ha venido experimentando y desarrollando unos modelos un tanto parecidos. Veamos.
This is our first time to show the urban air mobility business from Hyundai side, and we are super excited. The biggest feature of this vehicle is the vertical takeoff and landing with the powered by the electricity only. So this is a new concept of technology called like distributed electric propulsion. So compared to the helicopter, we can reduce the noise dramatically, and we can make we can assure the safety.
This is the first time for Sarcos Robotics to be here, and it's a big deal, because this is the first time that we're publicly displaying and demonstrating our full-body powered wearable robotic exoskeleton. We're here with our partner Delta Airlines to demonstrate use cases that Delta is going to be using it for in cargo loading and unloading, in repair and maintenance of their aircraft, and a whole variety of other situations. But it's got applicability across construction and manufacturing, warehousing and logistics, you name it.
We'll be right back.
showcasing some pretty cool concept technologies from the world of robotics. One is Bali, which is a robotic personal assistant that has the ability to maintain your living space or help you in the living space by connecting to the rest of the devices in your home that are also smart devices like your robot vac.
Y como en versiones anteriores, la automatización y la inteligencia artificial se robaron la atención también en la Feria CES de Las Vegas, pero en este caso trascendió al tema del arte, inteligencia artificial aplicada al arte, la cultura y en especial a la fotografía y la música.
At CES this year, we're excited about AI and applications of machine learning into our product design. So at Brunswick, we are focused on speech recognition, gesture recognition, object detection using computer vision technologies.
We are back at CES 2020 for the third year in a row with a newly developed and evolved sixth generation Forpheus, as well as all of its technologies in AI, robotics, social solutions, and healthcare, all on display here at CES.
Kyocera is delighted to be at CES 2020, and one of the items we're most excited to unveil for the first time in the U.S. is our AI-integrated automotive camera. It's a world's first to integrate deep learning, neural network-powered AI directly into the camera module, and it's going to give great advantages in object recognition, in determining the difference between a walking pedestrian, someone who's standing or crouching, vehicles, trucks and cars, motorcycles, and free space.
Ustedes se preguntarán por el futuro de la salud, pues en el CES conocimos herramientas que mejoren la experiencia del paciente y lo hacen que tome el control de su propio bienestar, diferentes aplicaciones y hasta un robot que nos puede ayudar en esta materia. Veamos el informe de cómo ahora la salud también hace parte del mundo de la tecnología.
This is the Confirm RX device made by Abbott. This device is an implantable cardiac monitor which continuously monitors the heartbeat 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year for 2 years, keeping a person connected all the time to their doctor and caregiver. This device is important because it keeps an individual connected, keeping an individual engaged in their own healthcare and connected with their doctor.
At my end, at CES 2020, we're demonstrating and showcasing our new platform. It's a textile computing platform on a 24 hours, and we're launching a new textile interface. Our brand is called Skin. Skin is a bidirectional interface that could connect you to yourself, also to IoT and AI.
Amran Healthcare is here at CES because we're transforming the heart health marketplace. We've got great inventions like HeartGuide, one of the Time best inventions of 2019, and we also have Amran Complete, which was the winner of one of the CES Innovation Awards. We want to make sure that there's a blood pressure monitor for each of the 103 million U.S. adults that has hypertension. We want everybody to know and watch their numbers.
La Feria CES o CES es el lugar para conocer todas las tecnologías en la agricultura, en la tecnología y en el desarrollo logístico, inclusive sobre realidad aumentada y realidad virtual. Algo de lo que venimos hablando en los últimos 20 años, pero que apenas se viene a concretar ahora. Vamos a entender un poco cómo funciona esto.
Hypervision is a 3D holographic digital technology that brings your imagery to life. But what we're really excited about now is we're able to control the imagery through different widgets and things that actually interact with the device, and things like a holographic game, which is Tetris, that we have here. First time ever done. So really excited about the new advancements that we have with these items. It's a virtual world that we're interacting with, and you're able not only to just play the game, but it's holographic in front of you. So it's live, it's real, and you're controlling it in the game itself. It's the next level of digital media.
Insta360 Titan, it is the best in class professional VR camera. It shoots super high resolution, 11K VR. And when you're shooting immersive content, that's super crucial because it's being spread over that entire sphere, which is why we had to go all out in putting 8 4K sensors on this camera. So we're shooting with 8 4K sensors, combining that together into one seamless image, and it gives you just amazingly high fidelity VR.
So TeslaSuit is our two-way communication interface between human body and a digital world, allowing us to run various simulations and digital twinning models between the body and the virtual reality and extended reality and augmented reality. Now the main purposes for suits to provide a new level of training. We're talking about virtual reality training, we're talking about augmented reality training, where people can actually learn by experience, live through different simulations we can provide.
Y la firma Mercedes-Benz, que antes le había apostado al tema de accesorios dentro del vehículo, ahora llegó pisando duro a la Feria CES de Las Vegas con un prototipo autónomo que definitivamente se robó muchas miradas.
We had someone ask earlier, why is a tire company at CES? And we said, well, that's a really great question. For us, the future is to not be a tire company. The future is to be a solutions company. So we see, look at the last 30 years, and we see the innovation and change that's happened in those 30 years. We think we're going to see more than that in the next 10 years. And so we as a company want to be ready for that and help lead that change. So we're making that shift from passive components more to proactive solutions and more digital solutions as we go forward.
Excited to be showing the lowest cost level 2 plus autonomous driving system on the market today. It's really going to help automakers bring this technology, comfort, better safety to consumers faster as we all move toward a level 4 or level 5 fully autonomous system, bringing that technology to consumers closer in the near term.
With Gentex Corporation, we are an electronic supplier to the automotive industry. We supply digital vision systems, connectivity products, and dimmable glass for the automotive industry. So we've got side and rear vision systems that replace mirrors using cameras and displays.
Here at BlackBerry, we're showing some very cool new technology in the automotive sector. We have a safety certified OS and a large set of features on top of that. We're showing Cylance integration, which is a machine learning security company. You know, we're working with AWS in an automotive context.
En el CES 2020, además, se presentaron los más recientes avances en el 5G, la confiabilidad, velocidad y las nuevas innovaciones que se traen a través de esta herramienta para aplicarlas a las diferentes industrias, incluso al entretenimiento, la salud digital y las ciudades sostenibles. Además, esta es la apuesta de las naciones.
Oh, there's so much going on in 5G. We've got tablet devices for agricultural use where you can use a drone and control the drone and look at your livestock and know, are my livestock where they should be? I can control farming equipment. I can utilize it in hospitality. But one of my personal favorites is what we do with our first responder community and in particular EMTs. They're out there to save lives.
We are Team Orbi, and today on CES 2020 we are presenting our 360 video recording 5G helmet for the American football. This helmet requires a really huge bandwidth to deliver the video to the end customer, and the only way to do this is 5G.
Intopix is a codec company, so we provide compression technologies for video. So basically, we compress and decompress the data. In the context of 5G, our technology is being used for live transmission between the camera and the end user. So produce sending the video with extremely low latency and preserving the quality.
¿Cómo es la tecnología combinada con resiliencia y con la ciudad? Muy sencillo para nosotros hoy en día, pero muy difícil de conectar en los últimos 20 años. Pero en CES o en la Feria CES en Las Vegas, muchos científicos han logrado conectar las tres cosas, las personas, las ciudades, el Internet de las cosas, a través del 5G, que es la próxima gran autopista del Internet y de la telefonía. Vamos a ver cómo a través de la resiliencia las ciudades inteligentes nos están dando ejemplo desde Medellín para el resto del mundo, hasta dónde podemos llegar trabajando, uniendo los puntos y pensando en futuro.
The Automotive Grade Linux Collaborative Project. We're building an open source software platform for the entire automotive industry. So what that means is our platform will be used by all of the automakers to build an entire platform for infotainment, instrument cluster, heads-up display, telematics, and eventually ADAS and autonomous vehicles.
We are IAV, we're an engineering services company, and what we're showing here at CES is some of our mobility solutions for smart cities. What we have is artificial intelligence system for climate control. We're also showing some really cool advanced technology for navigation systems. And what seems to be getting a lot of attention here is our cargo bike, which is a fully autonomous last mile delivery system.
What we're doing this year at CES 2020 is really looking at how we work with our customers to co-create solutions that are going to make the citizens' lives and citizens' communities better. We do that by going into the community, finding out what the issues are, and then with the customer, figuring out how to solve them. I've seen all sorts of great solutions this year at CES, and I can't wait to do it again.
Más de 1.200 empresas de más de 50 países estuvieron contando sus novedades en Eureka Park, el que podemos llamar el pabellón más grande de emprendimiento en todo el mundo.
So our product here is called Exo Rehab. So this product is innovative because it has a functional electrical stimulation with two biosignal detection systems. One is EMG and ROM, all at the same one product, and then we control it by tablet, and also the doctors and therapists can see and browse by the webpage.
Hi, it's TeleConnected. TeleConnected, the first smart and connected helmet, which combine in all-in-one solution all the problematic that biker can encounter on the roads. With the technology, biker could be accompanied, protected, and guided on the road, and they could practice their passion in the best safety condition.
Indigo Vision is here at CES 2020, and what we've developed is an innovative anti-blue light phone and tablet case. The harmful effects of blue light are digital eye strain, macular degeneration, headaches, migraines, and blurry eyes. And so what we have here is a case that effectively blocks 85% of that light.
Esa es la Feria CES o la Feria CES en Las Vegas, Nevada. Hace muchísimo frío durante esta temporada porque la feria es la primera en el año en el mes de enero. Pero hay muchas cosas importantes para entender aquí. La más importante de ellas creo que va a ser la tecnología orientada hacia las personas, hacia cómo ayudarnos a ser mejores ciudadanos y a desenvolvernos mejor con nuestras propias ciudades. Este evento se repetirá el próximo mes de enero, como venimos haciendo en los últimos dos años. Estaremos compartiendo con ustedes información de valor, tecnologías y novedades en la próxima feria.
¿Cómo no quedar maravillados hoy con los nuevos inventos, la robótica, los vehículos autónomos, los nuevos adelantos para la movilidad de las ciudades sostenibles y, por supuesto, que son pensados en el medio ambiente? Todo esto que vimos en el CES 2020 nos deja maravillados y, por supuesto, esperamos estar presentes en la próxima versión para contarles en Negocios en tu Mundo lo mejor de la feria más grande de tecnología en el mundo. Y además, con una sorpresa, puede que a futuro en América Latina se comiencen a hacer pequeños eventos de la magnitud del CES. Un gusto acompañarlos. Hasta la próxima.
Y con el agradecimiento muy especial a Linda Bustamante y Gabriel Posada por acompañarnos en este especial del CES de Las Vegas, nos despedimos y los esperamos en la próxima emisión de Negocios en tu Mundo. Inspiración para la acción.